back to the channel. Back out in Jeeps today, out with Farmer Chris, heading down to Dunglass Bridge. Basically, I'm just chumming Chris halfway home. Just been down in Dunbarren today. So, up Starvation Brae, down through the back end. I'm not doing much commenting on this, just like listening to the Jeeps squeaking and clunking and roaring away. They're going brilliant this now, really good, both of them. the change in the weather today after all the Saharan heat wave that we've had, and forecast thunder clouds, storms tonight, and it's probably black everywhere except right overhead right now. But we got home before it rained anyway, or I did anyway, I think Chris would have as well. But we've been needing the rain, wash a bit of the dust away, it's on everything. It was really warm. I've already done a film on all these bridges at Dunglass Dean. When I was out on the motorbike. I'll put the link for it below in this one. Stunning history here from the original bridges up to the present day road bridge. But this bridge that we're going on to is 1933 built concrete bridge. So Chris's claim to fame is it was him that put the bollards on this bridge with his forklift. He used to, his family used to farm Dunglass Estate. And so there you go. Pub quiz answer for you there, thing I've never asked you. Anyway, we've got some photos here I'm going to show you again in case you've never seen the other film. What's underneath this bridge? Still to be seen 80 years later in World War II.
Excellent! So this is the 1933 bridge, remember we did a video on it? What we'll do, you'll see up here, what they did under this during the war, is they had the explosives set to blow the bridge if we had been invaded, as this was the main road to Edinburgh for obvious reasons. Let's go and have a quick look under the bridge. You still see the cat's eyes where they were. Right, let's go and have a look underneath. 80 year old sandbags. Quite amazing.
Good they've not been kicked over or vandalised all. Living history, eh? So these Jeeps aren't showpieces sitting getting polished. We're using them. This is what they were built for. Scratches. Bumps, bashes, that's what they'll get. And just keep them running. I wish more folk would do stuff like this with vehicles like these. Land Rovers as well. So many old Land Rovers that don't get used. I don't get it. They're leaking oil into the garage doors for nothing. Anyway, we'll just stop on the older of the road bridges here.
All the best everyone, thanks again, see you soon, bye for now.